Hi guys, Hobbs here. Level 70 Pally in Scarlet Monastery Cathedral. If you remember my first video I ever made, I was level 63 and I had a full party. They were all level between 38 and 39 and they were assisting me with heals and area effect. And I was bubbling out of line of sight so that they wouldn't get aggro. Well, on this one, since I haven't done Scarlet Monastery video in a while, I thought I'd see how far I could go now that I've been level 70 for a bit and change a few of my items up. You also remember one other video I did, I believe I was level 65. It was a two pallies, one pull. And that's where we went up. We unlocked the doors before we got to the top, and then we went to the back without aggro and everything. Then we started from the beginning like this. And of course, we killed everything all in one pull. Now with this one though, it's just myself. You notice the pattern is very similar for those of you who have seen my other two videos. Very similar in the way that we're pulling up the bottom portion of the cathedral, the courtyard. Now I'm not going to go into a lot of detail on what effects and what spells and everything else I'm using, because you will notice in my first video, I do cover pretty well all of that. But of course, on this, the key is to make sure you dispel the slows as soon as they get popped on you. Otherwise, the mob does group on you, and then you're taking a lot more health loss than obviously if they're trailing behind. Been using the Skull Flame Shield for the first portion of the pull, help keeps my life up a bit. If you were watching the little sidebar here, when it all goes bright yellow, that's when it area effect procs and does about 100 and something damage to each person. Now I'm going to flip it over to the Petrified Lich and Guard, which is a great shield. I showed it in my Hobbs new items video. And of course, the poison effect, which is going to do the damage to all of them. That every time you block, you can have a chance of poisoning them, and of course, it is stackable. And that's going to help bring them down quicker as we get closer to the end. So you'll notice I didn't lock the doors. Sorry, I didn't unlock the doors at the beginning like I did in the two pallies, one pull. And I'm getting very low on health, dispelling the slow here. Got four more guys to pull, and then we got all of the outdoors covered. If you remember my first one, this is where I unlocked them and I ran back. And I got the health. I'm going down to about 321 when I bubbled there. And with this method, you can only do one heal because you need the time bubbled to open the door. So now I have a choice. I have a health potion or a swiftness potion. I pop the swiftness potion because it's actually going to lead you away from the mob, and therefore your health just stalls. Now I'm going to use my new trinket that you saw in my last Shattered Halls video, the excuse me, I'm going to use the figurine of the Colossus, and you're going to notice my health filled right up. Didn't use any mana. That's because each block that you do will do 120 health. And with the amount of people that are hitting me at this present moment, that's a lot of health. But you'll see I'm going down here. Popped on my Essence of Echiranus. It's another poison effect, so I'm stacking a bunch of things to hopefully kill them all off. We've already killed the main guy, and she's come out, put me to sleep. So now we've got the two bosses on. You'll see I'm getting very low here, very worried. Kind of pull back a little bit, hoping to take a little less damage. I've now thrown on my Seal of Light to try to regain some life every time I hit them. And of course, I'm keeping my block up. So I do have a Lay Hands available. But I really didn't want to do it. I wanted to see if I could do it all in one. So I'm gonna, because the casters you'll see are actually hitting me from the distance, what I got to do is get back to this pillar so I can pull him in closer. And of course, I'm walking backwards at this point, so I have the ability to block as well. This point, no mana, very little health. You'll see I click on the figurine of the Colossus. It's in the bottom right-hand corner, a few up on the sidebar, guys. And I've got a few seconds left, so If you remember just a couple of minutes ago, it filled me right up right when I got to the first boss here. And here we go, we pop it one more time. Now, it's not going to fill me up as fast, because now I only got about half a dozen guys hitting me. So, you know, you only have a few blocks in there, but it's still going to give me the advantage that I'm going to live through the pull. So at this point, I knew I had the battle won. It was just going to be some time. I'm going to speed it up here for you guys for a bit, because one thing with a Prot Pally is they hit weak. It's all about being hit and doing the damage that way. So I'm going to speed it up. Of course, thinking back, maybe I should have flipped up on one of my two-hand weapons. But regardless, that was SM Cath, one pull, one pally. Lots of loot to clean up there. In fact, I'm not going to show you all the looting process, but it took almost longer to loot than it did to kill everything. I mean, there's a ton of them out there. We're just down to one last guy, and we're good to go. There we go. So, gonna loot it all up, and I'll tell you, it was a tough battle. Almost died a few times. Still had the lay hands left. Still didn't use a health potion. And now it's just a matter of cleaning this all up. If you like my videos, guys, subscribe. Because I'll have more out in the future, plus you can look back at the other ones I have. If you like this one, add it to your favorites. Of course, rate it. Let me know how I'm doing. Rate it high, rate it low, whatever you think it deserves. Now, of course, the Hobbs way of pulling just isn't about showing what one pally can do. I've never been about soloing, but a lot of people have asked, can you solo it? So I tried it more for my viewers than for myself, because 9 times out of 10, I'm bringing other people here trying to get them level and experience. And of course, I can do all 4 instances now, one pull, like this. When I'm doing the armory, if I have a party, I keep them at the beginning, I run to the very end, I unlock the door, wind bubble, just like you saw here, I grab the boss, I call them in at that moment, because by the time they run through the whole instance, I've got everybody on me, I've used my figurine of the Colossus. I've went back a little bit into the hallway just before the boss, because there's actually 4 other adds there that block off the hall, so that way you can get them a little bit more experience, a little bit more loot, and plus they won't aggro the party as they walk through. So just showing a few moments here of some of the pulls when I do have people anywhere from level sometimes 30 all the way up to 41, but usually in the mid-lower 30s is where we keep them. Really glad I did the videos before I hit 70, obviously, because I wanted to show it wasn't all about just doing it at 70. I've been doing SM for a long time. In fact, I started around 45 pulling like this. Of course, the mobs were a lot lower, but then again, the party got a lot more experience per kill because I was a lot lower level, so we'd rip through it pretty quick. And of course, with the library, I pull right to the end, come back. The last 2 hallways will path back, but you'll have the majority of the instance on you, and then the party members will get the loot from the boss, the bind on pickup, which there's some nice drops there for casters. And graveyard, really, I've been able to do that at least since from what I can remember, 60, the whole thing. It's been an easy one. Of course, it's the lowest of the 4. Well, guys, I'm going to leave you with a few scenes of the Hobbs way of pulling. And thanks again for watching. Make sure to check out my blog at wowhobbs.blogspot.com. I'm going to have and take a look at my other 2 SM videos, because just to compare the two. It's been a nice difference in comparison. I even remember the difference between level 60 and 63 from when I made my first video was huge. So it's going to be interesting to see when the expansion comes out what level 80 brings and what changes it brings in the Hobbs way of pulling. Thanks again for watching, guys, and until next time.